A group of Vermont business leaders today pleaded with the state Senate to postpone a vote on relicensing the Vermont Yankee nuclear power plant at least for another month. They said senators ought to have key reports, which they have requested and which aren't done yet, to make the best decision. News Channel 5's Stuart Ledbetter has the details.
We have to be smarter than this.
Computer giant IBM joining employer groups across Vermont to blast State Senate Leader Peter Shumlin. Shumlin demanding a vote this week on relicensing Vermont Yankee. They called it a needless rush to judgment.
History has shown us in Vermont that decisions about long-term power supply are easy to get wrong. And we really cannot afford as a state to get this decision wrong.
For Big Blue, the state's largest electricity consumer.
To cut off one-third of our power without having an alternative plan is reckless.
Adding a spike in power rates could have, quote, very dramatic consequences. Such is the tension surrounding Shumlin's surprise decision to call the vote, though it's actually a non-binding vote and the nuclear plant won't close for two more years. It has a lot of people nervous.
It's common sense to retire on schedule. It's the right thing to do.
Please contact your legislators now.
The anti-nuclear groups are running TV ads to ramp up pressure.
We're working real hard. We're doing everything that we can. This is a really important issue to Vermonters.
The emails that I've gotten run 9-1 or 10, 15-1 against Yankee.
Despite any of the, again, as I'll call it, smoke and mirrors that were presented today, I think the legislative body, and the Senate in particular, is being very responsive and responsible to the Vermont, or to the people of Vermont.
It's a huge decision, and the Senate leadership says it's determined to debate and vote on Wednesday. At the State House in Montpelier, Stuart Ledbetter, News Channel 5.